It's your man George Page coming to you live on YouTube. Anyway, I saw this. It was posted on our Facebook page, which is managed by man Jason Rose, our Lion's Den Women's Mixed Martial Arts Community page, you know, or the LDWMMAC, that one Miss Miranda the Maverick, you know, Miranda Maverick, is making her debut at UFC on ESPN 12 against Mara Romero Borrello. Now, as you know, the last time that the Maverick fought was back in February when she faced Pearl Gonzalez, and she beat the Pearl, you know, and this was possibly was maybe a chance for a shot at the 125 title in Invicta and against Vanessa Porto. But because right now with so few fighters who want to fight during this whole epidemic and just everything going on, that, you know, she got an opportunity to step up. Like, it's just a week notice, because this weekend is the upcoming ESPN on ESPN fights coming up. And the headliner is Justin Poirier versus Dan Hooker. Also on that card is Sarah McMahon versus Aspen Ladd. And Alexa Grasso stepped up to 125 herself, making her debut against Jin Yu Kim. Now, the last time that Mara Borrella fought was when she fought Courtney Casey, when she made a debut as a 125er, and that was back in May. And my man Coach likes to talk about this a lot, about how Mara, how'd she get out of that drug charge? She snitched. She's a snitch. That's the only way you get out of a drug charge like that. She dropped some names, and enough names where, you know what, she was a small fish and threw it back. That's how she got out. We're not too much a big fan of Miranda Maverick. She was throwing some shade on Tanisha Tennant, who fought in the Invictus Phoenix tournament a while ago. And we're a big fan of Tanisha. Tanisha is going to be wearing the CS Combat Sports patch on her uniform next time she fights. I'm hoping, like, you know, Invicta supposed to have a fight coming up in a little bit, Invicta 40, and, you know, but this is a big, you know, this is a big step up for Miranda. As you know, at one point we were a fan of Maverick. You know, my man, the coach, did an interview with her. I think she's an amazing fighter. She's very strong. She was 3-1 back in Invicta, with only loss to Deanna Bennett. She defeated Pearl Gonzalez for maybe, well, I thought would be opportunity to fight for the Invicta 125 title. But now she's getting a step up. She's, you know, like, you know, usually the last couple of fighters have been picked up by Invicta, you know, for Invicta by UFC have been title holders, like Felicia Spencer, Verna Jodoroba, and Brianna Van Buren. But, you know, this time we got a fighter who hasn't even won a title yet, but she has to prove herself in 125. What her future's going to be? It might be a good future. She's a good, like I said, you know, besides this thing throwing shade against Tanisha Tennant, she's a good fighter. She's strong. She's very well built, you know. I might put in the list as one of the most buff women in MMA. But, you know, Mara Borrella has been a punching bag for the past couple of years in UFC. And, you know, I'm surprised, you know, she's stepping up because, hey, you know, she's over here. She's probably trying to make some money for herself, especially with this whole pandemic going on. And there's a good chance that she can't go back to Italy. not because of the coronavirus, because there's some big dogs back there probably waiting for her. So I'm not going to say good luck to Miranda. You know, like I said, she, you know, but I'm going to say have a good fight. And maybe it's a possibly a chance for Mara to break her pretty much a loser streak. It's your man, George Page. Like, subscribe. Don't subscribe. I'm out.